हेलो।
हेलो
ओम सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यंकरवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम नमः पाणिनि कात्यायन पतंजलिभ्यः शब्द विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो मुनिभ्यो गुरुभ्यः केयूरान विभूषयन्ति पुरुषं हारान चंद्रोज्ज्वला न स्नानं न विलेपनं न कुसुमं नालंकृतामूर्धजा वाण्येका समलंकरोति पुरुषं या संस्कृता धार्यते क्षीयन्ते खलु भूषणानि सततं वाग्भूषणं भूषणं। वेल डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड लवर्स एंड लर्नर्स ऑफ संस्कृत, welcome to the 16th class. We had a miss on the previous class due to some problem. Now we have been doing various exercises with regard to the verbs and personal pronouns and other pronouns and verbs in the third person, second person, first person. Last class we have studied थर्ड पर्सन प्रथम पुरुष मध्यम पुरुष उत्तम पुरुष वर्ब्स वेरियस वर्ब्स हैव बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड हियर अलोंग विद द टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोनाउंस पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस अस्मद एंड युष्मद। वी हैव कम अप टू द पेज 129 वी हैव कंप्लीटेड बाय द लास्ट क्लास वेर इन वी हैड अ प्रैक्टिस ऑफ वर्तमान काल त्रिषु पुरुषेषु क्रियापदानि इन द थ्री पर्सन्स ऑल द थ्री वर्ब्स वी हैव स्टडीड एंड वी आर ऑन टुडे पेज 130 एंड वी गो हियर। प्लीज रीड केयरफुली इज द इंस्ट्रक्शन। हियर अगेन डिफरेंट प्रोनाउन इज यूज्ड इंट्रोड्यूस्ड हियर। अ रेस्पेक्टफुल प्रोनाउन एज वी से इन इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस वी हैव टू वेज ऑफ एड्रेसिंग। वन वे इज वेरी addressing a younger person and another way is addressing while addressing an elder person. There is a different pronoun used, like in Hindi tum, which is derived from tvam Sanskrit, and aap, which is also derived, they say, from the word Sanskrit word aapta. From the aapta word aap is derived. Aap is a honorific, a respectful way of addressing elderly person. And tum or tvam, which we use in Sanskrit, is ekavachana of ishmat chabda, that is addressing younger people, people of inferior positions, etc. So here we have a pronoun here coming, bhavat chabda, that is bhavan. In the picture you can see tvam aham chhatraha. The aham is a pronoun coming from the asmad pronoun, which has which is equal in all the three. Trishulingeshu samana asmat shabda. Asmad shabda is same in all the three genders. You have noticed already, every pronoun has genders. Like tad pronoun becomes saha in pullinga, sa in strilinga, tat in napumsakalinga. And kim pronoun becomes like that in pullinga, it is derived separately, strilinga and napumsakalinga. Every noun and pronoun is derived in three genders. But this pronoun, asmad, I, yushmad, you, have no genders. Because the speaker can be a feminine person, the speaker can be a masculine person, sometimes a machine may also speak. So, trishulingeshu samana, it is same in all the three genders. There you are saved because of no more generalized. So aham could be anybody. So aham chhatraha, He says, now here the honorific, as I said, pronoun is Bhavan. The young student in the picture is addressing the teacher, Bhavan Adhyapakaha. You are a teacher. But well, in English you have to say you only. And that you is plural of thou in English. And that you in English is very close to our Sanskrit. Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam, which is plural. Plural shows you know, respect also. So Yuyam, so Bhavan is some such pronoun here. Adhyapakaha, which means aap adhyapak hai in Hindi. In Telugu we may say differently, tamaru meeru, which is different from tvam. So aham balakaha bhavan vriddha, aham sevakaha bhavan rupaha, aham nartaki bhavan gayaka. So this bhavan is for masculine. For addressing a lady, we have a change in the pronoun there. But whereas if you use tvam instead of aham chatraha, tvam adhyapakaha, you can say tvam adhyapika, tvam mahila, that tvam has no gender variation, but this bhavan has gender. It changes with gender. We will see later feminine will be used. So in this speech you are introduced to aham and bhavan. So that much you please follow, and then we move on here. And on page 131 again you are reading aham and bhavan only. Aham chatraha asmi. Now here, aham chatraha asmi. You know by now the viewers must be aware of the verb pattern asmi, swaha, smaha. We studied in the previous class. Three persons, if you recall the three persons, third person, prathama purusha, ekavachana, dvivachana, bahuvachana would be asti. Can you recall? Asti, staha, santi. Asti, staha, santi. Second person, madhyama purusha, asi, staha, stha. Uttama purusha, first person, asmi, swaha, smaha, smaha. So this is the regular verb, asa, to be, and that is used here. Now there is something to be told here. Aham chatraha asmi, which is very simple. I am a student. Asmi, am, equivalent to am in English. Bhavan adhyapakaha, we don't use the second person asi here. In bhavat shabda yoga, when you use bhavat shabda, this bhavan, you have to use the third person verb only. Although it is a pronoun of honor in second person, the verb must be third person only. I cannot say bhavan adhyapakaha asi. This is wrong. Bhavat shabda yoga prathama purusha eva, that is the ruling there. You have to use the third person verb only with bhavat, this bhavan. We cannot use, because since it is not equivalent to tvam, so we use maybe third person. So bhavan adhyapakaha asti. If the sentence were to be tvam adhyapakaha, then what comes? Asi. Tvam adhyapakaha asi. You are a teacher. But it is not like that. We are learning the usage of bhavan here. Bhavan adhyapakaha asti. We don't use, so that remark will come somewhere later. Aham balaha, now you can go with this. Aham balaha asmi. Bhavan vriddha asti. Aham sishyaha asmi. Bhavan acharyaha asti. Aham sevakaha asmi. Bhavan rupaha asti. Aham sthulaha asmi. Bhavan krushaha asti. Sthulaha krushaha meaning, you know, I think. Sthulaha fat. Krushaha lean. Aham vamanaha asmi. I am short. Bhavan unnataha asti. You are taller. Aham samanyaha asmi. I am a commoner. Bhavan shrestaha asti. You are very good, the best. Aham anujaha asmi. I am a younger brother. Bhavan agrajaha. Now these are two opposite words. Anujaha. born later, younger. Agra jaha, born earlier, elder. So that is how the words are used. Agra jaha, elder brother. Anujaha, younger brother. Aham anujaha asmi, I am younger. Bhavan agra jaha, you are elder brother. Aham aswastaha asmi, bhavan chikitsaha asti. Aham aswastaha asmi, I am unwell, I am not doing well. Bhavan chikitsakaha asti, you are a doctor. Aham chanchalaha asmi, chanchala word is simple, I am very fickle, I am fickle. Bhavan nischalaha asti, you are stable. Opposite of chanchala is nischala. Now this way, here in these two pages we have studied the usage of aham and bhavan. Aham is of course was studied in the previous class also, but now here you are introduced to the word bhavan, pronoun in honorific usage, and the feminine is introduced in this page on page 132 with along with the personal pronoun aham bhavati. Aham chhatraha. Now, as I told you just now, this bhavat, bhavat, bhavan shabda has a gender. Tvam doesn't have any gender. Aham doesn't have any gender. Aham chhatraha, bhavati adhyapika. Now, bhavan has gone, bhavati has come. So, bhavati is like a noun. Which noun we studied like this previously? Strilinga shabda. Strilinga shabda. Which strilinga? Nadi. Gauri. Ikaranta strilinga. So this bhavati shall be derived like ikaranta nadi shabda. That you have to remember. And adhyapika shabda is like akaranta lata. Lata shabda. So all the learners in the beginning, you should focus your mind on the words and their endings, and then come to an understanding whether it is a masculine noun or feminine noun, whether it is akaranta, whether it is ikaranta, and then recall the previously learnt noun. Akaranta, you can make one noun as a model noun, whether kanya, lata, rama. Ikaranta, nadi would be better, nadi shabda. Ikaranta, akaranta pullinga if it is Rama Shabda or Deva Shabda, ikaranta Kavi Shabda. So we have studied very few, two in masculine, maybe two in feminine. So please identify that way. Aham balakaha asmi, bhavati vruddha asti. Now that verb is not here, but we can use it. Aham balakaha asmi, bhavati vruddha asti. Then aham anujaha asmi, bhavati agraja. Now in the previous page, anujaha, younger brother. Here anu agraja is used. Agrajaha, young, elder brother. Same word in feminine becomes agraja. Agrajaha, agraja. Just a small derivation, feminine derivation. Agrajaha, this is pullinga, feminine part of it is agraja, strilinga. So this is elder brother, this is elder sister. Oh, what is happening? Anuja, opposite is anujaha. Opposite of this is anujaha. Anujaha and anuja. Anujaha, anuja. Elder brother and elder sister. So bhavati vruddha asti, aham anujaha, bhavati agraja. Aham putri asmi, bhavati janani asti. Very very simple words here. So this is how you have to learn the usage of Bhavan and Bhavati in the respectful addressing. Then comes again the same practice on the 133 page. Tvam Bhavan, Tvam Bhavati. So Bhavan, Bhavati, both are introduced here for your practice. Tvam Chhatraha. Now we studied Aham so far in 2-3 pages. Tvam Chhatraha, Bhavan Adhyapakaha. We can recall the verb Tvam Chhatraha Asi. Now here the verb has to be like this. Tvam, I will write one here. Chhatraha Asi. What is the opposite? Bhavan. Bhavan Adhyapakah Asti. So with Bhavan or Bhavati you use Asti here. With Tvam you use Asi. Tvam guides this, Bhavan guides this. Tvam Sevakah Asi. Again, Tvam Asi. Tvam Sevakah Asi. Bhavan Rupah Asti. Asti. Bhavan Rupah. Tvam Chhatraha Asi. Bhavati Bhavati Adhyapika Asti. You are a teacher. Tvam Balakah Asi. Bhavati Janani Asti. Tvam Anuja Asi. Asi. Bhavati Agraja Asti. So Anuja, just now I wrote here, Anuja, same as this. So this is how Bhavan, Bhavati, very simple. Only thing is, with Bhavan you use Asti, with Bhavati also you use Asti. That should be there. And whenever Tvam comes, Asi only must be used in the verb form. Now what is there on Abhyasa 68, 134 page? Aham Asmi Bhavati Asti. Practice. Now you look at the udaharana and write sentences according to Aham Chhatra Asmi. Now here is a sentence. What is the gender, Srinivasgar? Aham Chhatra Asmi.
Strilinga.
So Bhavati Adhyapika Asti. Bhavati Adhyapika Asti. You are a teacher. Aham Balika Asmi. Everywhere Asmi comes here, irrespective of the gender. If the speaker, the gender may be masculine, may be pullinga, may be strilinga, or may be napumsakalinga, Asmi only comes here. So, Bhavati Jyeshta Asti. Third one, Aham Balakah Asmi. Bhavati Janani Asti. Aham Lipikarah Asmi. Bhavati Sevika Asti. Aham Paricharika Asmi. Now Lipikarah, writer. Paricharika, maid servant. Paricharika. Aham Paricharika Asmi. Bhavati Pracharya Asti. You are a professor. Lady professor. Aham Vadakah Asmi. I am an instrument player. Bhavati Gayika Asti. You are a singer. Female singer. Aham Sahayakah Asmi. I am a helper. Bhavati Pramukha Asti. You are an important lady. Aham Alpagnah Asmi. I am I am a knower, little knower. I know little, I am a little knower. Bhavati Bahugna Asti. You know more. Aham Pujakah Asmi. I am a worshipper. Bhavati Pujya Asti. You are respectable. Aham Antimaha Asmi. I am the last one. Bhavati Prathama Asti. You are the first one. So this way, Bhavati, Bhavan, Asti, Asmi. This is the practice we have seen in the four pages. On page 135, if you please turn to that, watch carefully. What you find, you will see here. Fill up in the bottom of the page, Bhavan, Bhavantau, Bhavantah, and then Bhavan. So okay, only Bhavan, Bhavantau, Bhavantah. Here in this page, the book is showing the derivation of this Bhavan Shabda. How is it derived in three persons? Bhavan, Bhavantau, Bhavantah. So this is Prathama. And this is Ekavachana, singular, dual, Dvivachana, and this is Bahuvachana, plural. Bhavan, Bhavantau, Bhavantah. Like some Bhavan means one, Bhavantau, you two, in respectful way of saying, Bhavantah, you all. Which is in a way equal to Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam. But Tvam does not have that honorific addressing. So this has it. Bhavan Adhyapakaha, Bhavantau Adhyapakau. You both are teachers. Bhavantaha Adhyapakaha. In India, while speaking, we don't use Sanskrit is spoken in India, in many parts of country, in West Bengal, in Karnataka, and in many, many sister. So in traditional schools and colleges and meetings, Sanskrit is very fluently spoken. It is not that Sanskrit is a total unspoken language. It is a spoken language. And this book, the intention of the book is to take you to that stage where I will also be switching over totally to speak in Sanskrit slowly. So while speaking, we use this Bhavan only. We don't use Tvam. Yuvam, Yuyam, Bhavan Atra Agachatu, please come here, Bhavan Upavishatu, we will say, but we will not say Tvam Atra Agacha, Tvam Upavisha, which is not correct. So that is how it is. Bhavan Adhyapakaha, Bhavantau Adhyapakau, Bhavantaha Adhyapakaha. So Bhavan, Bhavantau, Bhavantaha. What is the parallel pronoun? We studied Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam. Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam, if you recall. It doesn't take much time, I'll write that also. Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam. So, Bhavan Asti, and then in the third column, he is giving you with a verb. Bhavan Asti, Bhavantau Staha, Bhavantaha Santi. Showing you the how the verb should be used with this Bhavan. Bhavan we have already seen asti. Bhavan chatraha asti. Bhavan adhyapakaha asti. Bhavati adhyapika asti. Bhavati janani asti. Anywhere you use that. So here some exercise for you, the viewers. Bhavan, so please go with fifth one. Bhavan jeshtaha, what will you add here? Verb? What up to?
Up to two.
Why? Scanning is not there?
No, it's there.
Huh?
We have computer only two.
Third one I have done it. Bhavan asti, Bhavantau staha, Bhavantaha santi. The verb is used here. Asti staha santi. Now what verb is to be used with Bhavan? We have already seen in the previous page. Bhavan asti asti. So when Bhavantau staha santi, asti staha santi verb has to be used here. So now you go. Bhavan adhyap.
Jeshtaha asti.
Asti. Bhavan, please look to viewers. Bhavan jeshtaha, fifth sentence. Bhavan jeshtaha asti. Bhavantau jeshtau staha. Staha. Bhavantaha jeshtaha santi. Jeshtaha meaning elder, eldest. You are the eldest. You both are the eldest. You all are the eldest. Bhavan bodhakaha asti. Sixth sentence I am reading. Bhavan bodhakaha asti. You are a teacher. Bhavantau bodhakau staha. So the noun also changed into dvivachana. Bhavantau bodhakau staha. Bhavantaha bodhakaha santi. You are teachers. Bodhaka is also a teacher, instructor, something. Bhavan desha bhaktaha asti. You are a desha bhakta. What do you say? Patriot. Bhavantau desha bhaktau staha. You both are patriots. Bhavantaha desha bhaktaha santi. Asti staha santi. Going with bhavan, bhavantau, bhavantaha. What goes with tvam is different verb. Verb will be matching there. So, just tvam should not confuse you here. Next. Bhavan pramukha asti. Bhavantau pramukhau staha. Bhavantaha pramukaha santi. Bhavan nirdeshakaha asti. Director. Nirdeshakam is director. Bhavan nirdeshakaha asti. Bhavantau nirdeshakau staha. Bhavantaha nirdeshakaha santi. Bhavan tantrajnaha asti. Engineer. An engineer is called tantrajna. Bhavan tantrajnaha asti. Bhavantau tantrajnau staha. Bhavantaha tantrajnaha santi. So the noun part is easier. It is just like our previously studied akaranta pullinga shabda. Devaha, devau, devaha. Asti staha santi. Bhavan bhavantau bhavantaha. That is the. So is it okay?
Yeah.
So wherever new words are coming, I am giving the meaning.
No, we are doing this exercise. We will repeat it twice.
This one?
Anyway.
Okay, you can do now. Yeah, better. So do the exercise. Fifth one onwards. Bhavan, you do it now. Bhavantau. Very good. Bhavantaha. Santi. Bhavan bodhakaha asti. Bhavantau. Staha bhavantaha bodhaka santi. Bhavan desha bhakta asti. Bhavantau staha bhavantaha bhaktaha santi. Bhavan pramukha asti. Bhavantau
pramukhau staha.
Yes.
Bhavantau
pramukaha santi. Bhavan
nirdeshakah
asti. निर्देशकौ स्तः भवन्तः निर्देशकाः सन्ति. भवान् तंत्रज्ञः अस्ति. भवन्तौ
तंत्रज्ञौ
स्तः. यस.
भवन्तः
तंत्रज्ञाः सन्ति. सो दिस इज हाउ यू लर्न भवत् भवान् शब्द विथ वर्ब. देन ऑन द नेक्स्ट पेज द सेम थिंग इन फेमिनिन जेंडर. भवति भवत्यौ भवत्यः. Bhavati bhavatyau bhavatyaha. Bhavati भवत्यौ भवत्यः. फेमिनिन. सो वी गो हियर. भवति फर्स्ट. द फर्स्ट कॉलम इज इंट्रोड्यूसिंग यू टू द डेरिवेशन ऑफ द वर्ड with the pictures. Bhavati, bhavatyau, two females. Bhavatyah, many females, ladies. So then you go to next step. Second step is bhavati adhyapika. You can recall the verb asti. Bhavati, bhavati adhyapika asti. Bhavatyau adhyapike stah. Bhavatyah adhyapikah santi. So asti stah santi must be remembered here to use this pronoun. Very simple. Asti स्थाह संति। दिस इज थर्ड पर्सन वर्ब। देन वी हैव टू रीड द थर्ड कॉलम। भवती अस्ति, भवत्यौ स्तः सेम, भवत्यः सन्ति। देन सम एक्सरसाइज विल डू। भवती अध्यापिका अस्ति, भवत्यौ अध्यापिके स्तः, भवत्यः अध्यापिकाः सन्ति। नाउ टेल मी, अध्यापिका इज विच शब्द? आकारांत स्त्रीलिंग शब्द। व्हाट इज द शब्द वी स्टडीड प्रीवियसली? लता, कना, कन्या, एनीथिंग। लता, लता, लते, लताः, कन्या, कन्ये, कन्याः, अध्यापिका, अध्यापिके, अध्यापिकाः। सो वी गो विद फिफ्थ सेंटेंस। भवती प्राचार्या अस्ति, भवत्यौ प्राचार्ये स्तः, भवत्यः प्राचार्याः सन्ति। प्रोफेसर, प्राचार्यम्। भवती उत्तमा अस्ति, भवत्यौ उत्तमे स्तः, भवत्यः उत्तमाः सन्ति। सेवेंथ। भवती चतुरा अस्ति, चतुरा मीन्स क्लेवर, यू आर अ वेरी क्लेवर लेडी। भवती चतुरा अस्ति, भवत्यौ चतुरे स्तः, भवत्यः चतुराः सन्ति। भवती नर्तकी अस्ति, नदी लाइक। हियर ईकारांत इज कमिंग, ईकारांत थ्री वर्ड्स, एट, नाइन, टेन। भवती नर्तकी अस्ति, भवत्यौ नर्तक्यौ स्तः, भवत्यः नर्तक्यः सन्ति। देयर द मैचिंग इज गोइंग। भवती इज ईकारांत, नर्तकी इज ईकारांत, बोथ डिराइव सेम वे। भवती गृहिणी अस्ति, भवत्यौ गृहिण्यौ स्तः, भवत्यः गृहिण्यः सन्ति। भवती पूज्या अस्ति, भवत्यौ पूज्ये स्तः, भवत्यः पूज्याः सन्ति। नाउ दिस शुड नॉट बी ए प्रॉब्लम फॉर लर्नर्स डेरिवेशन। नर्तकी, एनीथिंग यू थिंक शुड बी रिटन हियर? नर्तकी डेरिवेशन, गृहिणी, विच वन? पूज्या, पूज्या, पूजे, पूजा, लाइक लता, लते, लता, आकारांत स्त्रीलिंग शब्द। विल अगेन डू दिस फोर्थ वन ऑनवर्ड्स। भवती अध्यापिका अस्ति, भवत्यौ अध्यापिके, भवत्यः अध्यापिकाः सन्ति। भवती प्राचार्या अस्ति, भवत्यौ प्राचार्ये स्तः, भवत्यः प्राचार्याः सन्ति। भवती अस्ति, भवत्यौ उत्तमे स्तः, भवत्यः उत्तमाः सन्ति। भवती चतुरा अस्ति, भवत्यौ चतुरे स्तः, भवत्यः चतुराः सन्ति। भवती नर्तकी अस्ति, भवत्यौ नर्तक्यौ स्तः, भवत्यः नर्तक्यः सन्ति। भवती गृहिणी अस्ति, भवत्यौ गृहिण्यौ स्तः, भवत्यः गृहिण्यः सन्ति। भवती पूज्या अस्ति, भवत्यौ पूज्ये स्तः, भवत्यः पूज्याः सन्ति। ऐ विल् ओन्ली रैट् दिस् नर्तकी, गृहिणी फार् दि सेक् आफ् दि It is not that difficult to derive. Nartaki derives like this. One form is already there. Nartaki, Nartakyau, Nartakyaha. Okay, Gruhini derives. Both are ikaranta strilinga shabdas. Gruhini, gruhinyau, gruhinyaha. So this is how it is derived. Puja is simple. Puja, puja, puja. Like lata, lati, lata. So we move on to the next page. Here again, whatever we studied so far are recalled here now. Verbs. All the verbs are again, once again recalled here in 69th Abhyasa on page 137. See, Bhavan. So please watch the viewers. On the right corner of the page, all the verbs are given there. Asti, staha, santi, asi, staha, stha, asmi, swaha, smaha. Now you have to select from these 9 verbs which one to be used where. That is the exercise here. With bhavan, bhavati, as already we have done, with this bhavan and bhavati, you use only asti verb. With tvam pronoun, you use asmi. With tvam is asi, second person, second row. With yushmat chabda, you use second row. With asmad, I pronoun, you use the first person. So these are the first line is third person, second line is second person, first person. But with these pronouns of second person, we use only third person verb. Bhavan asti, I wouldn't say bhavan asi. I cannot use second person. I will only use, so that is the practice, let us do it. Bhavan asti, bhavan asti, bhavantau staha, bhavantah santi, bhavan asti, bhavantau staha, bhavantah santi, bhavan vaidyah asti, bhavantau vaidyau staha, bhavantah vaidyah santi. So bhavan adhyapakah asti, भवन्तौ अध्यापकौ स्तः भवन्तः अध्यापकाः सन्ति भवती अध्यापिका अस्ति भवत्यौ अध्यापिके स्तः भवत्यः अध्यापिकाः सन्ति सो दैट इज हाउ इट इज यूज्ड देन भवन्तौ वैद्यौ
अस्ति
नो
स्तः
भवन्तौ इज ड्यूअल नंबर द्विवचन भवन्तौ वैद्यौ स्तः भवान वैद्यः अस्ति भवान अस्ति अगेन भवान अस्ति इन द लास्ट भवन्तौ फिफ्थ सेंटेंस स्तः भवन्तः सन्ति भवन्तः वैद्याः आई एम सॉरी भवन्तः सन्ति सेकंड वन इज आल्सो सन्ति भवन्तः वैद्याः सन्ति भवत्यः गृहिण्यः सन्ति Here, bhavati shabda is used. Bhavati, bhavatyau, bhavatya. Bhavatyau, bhavatyau, staha, staha, second. Bhavatyaha santi, bhavati asti. Here, second number, second person, plural, bahuvachana, ekavachana is given. Just to confuse you. Bhavatyau, I repeat it, seventh one. Bhavatyau, staha, bhavantyaha santi. Bhavati asti. If you come back from left to right, bhavati asti, bhavatyaha santi, bhavatyau staha. So in a bhavan, eighth one, asti, bhavantau staha, bhavantaha santi. It is going asti staha santi, bhavan asti bhavant. Tvam, now comes the tvam, which is purely second person verb to be used. Tvam asi. Yuvam staha, yuyam stha. Then, bhavan vaidyaha
asti.
Bhavati vaidya asti. Bhavantau adhyapakau
staha.
No doubt. Bhavantau adhyapakau, you have a doubt, you look at the noun. Whether it is dual or plural or singular. Bhavantau adhyapakau staha. 11th one. Tvam chhatraha. Asi. Whenever tvam comes, asi. Tvam chhatraha, asi. Supposing in the place of tvam, bhavan was there. Bhavan chhatraha asti. The verb changes to asti. So tvam chhatraha asi. Tvam balika asi. Irrespective of the noun. Tvam balika asi. Yuvam chhatrau staha, yuvam chatrav staha. You both are students. Then 12th one, bhavatyau bhaginyau staha. Staha, asti staha. Bhavatyau bhaginyau staha. You both are sisters. Bhagini is sister. Bhavati janani asti. You are a mother. Bhavantah chatraha santi. You are students. 13th. Bhavantau staha. Bhavan bhavantau bhavantah. Bhavantau staha. Bhavatyah santi. Bhavan asti. Bhavantah adhyapakah santi. Bhavatyah adhyapikah santi. Bhavatyau adhyapike staha. 15th. Bhavati adhyapika asti. Bhavan adhyapakah asti. Bhavantau adhyapakau staha. 16. Yuyam stha. Second person. Tvam yuvam yuyam. Yuyam asi stha stha. Yuyam stha. Bhavan asti. No confusion. You have to recall. Yuyam stha bhavan asti bhavatyah adhyapikah santi. 17. Yuvam chatrau staha. Here asi staha should be yuvam chatrau staha. Yuyam chatrah stha stha. Tvam chatrah tvam chatra asi. Tvam chatra asi. You are a female student. Tvam chatra asi. 18th. Yuyam sishyah stha. Only stha. Visargalit. Tvam chatra asi. Tvam chatra asi. Avam mitre staha. Now here, watch. Avam is aham avam. Dual number. Mitram mitre. Neuter noun is used. Mitram mitre mitrani. We have studied that. Avam mitre swaha. Asmi swaha. You pick up the first person. Here asmi swaha smaha. Avam mitre swaha. Yuyam mitrani stha. Vayam chatraha. No, vayam. First person plural. Smaha smaha. Vayam chatraha smaha. Aham adhyapika asmi. Asmi. Here the confusion is coming at the end for you. Let us, I don't know where the book is giving all the next page only it is giving. Next page is clarifying this doubt. Anyway, I will just write down for the sake of we go with the third person here. Bhavan oblique bhavati asti. This is bhavantau bhavat bhavati bhavatyau staha. The third I am not able to. Bhavantaha bhavatyaha santi. Now please watch the verb here. Asti staha santi. Then this is a pronoun. Then the pronoun tvam, we take tvam Asi. Okay? Then Yuvam.
Staha.
Yuyam. This is second person. This is also second person, but with a different verb and first person. Aham Asmi. Instead of this, I will put a dash here. Avam Swaha. Vayam Smaha. So whenever, now for these two there is no gender variation, there won't be any gender. Aham Asmi, Tvam Asi, Yuvam Staha, Yuyam Staha. Aham Asmi, Avam Swaha, Vayam Smaha. But with only these things you should go. Where? Third person, we are only dealing with personal pronouns only, I and you. This is equivalent to you only. So I wrote a second person. This is also treated like second person, but with respect. Respectful, honorific word. Bhavan, bhavati, asti. Bhavantau, bhavatyau, staha. Bhavantaha, bhavatyaha, santi. We don't use. With this, it is used in second person only, but verb is third person with that special usage. Shall we do this page again? Not necessary. It's big. Page 137. It is clear in the next page though, it will be more clarified. Next page. So please, viewers, watch this. You will not have any confusion. With these Bhavan, Bhavati, we use third person. And with Tvam, you only use the regular verb, Yuvamstaha, Yuyamstha, and Ahamasmi, Avamswaha, which is there in the book very clearly. Not together. So, we have, you may have a doubt here on page 137 while doing Yuyam Shishyaha, Stha only you should use, Tvam Chatraha, Asi. Wherever Tvam comes, you have to use Asi, second person. Page 138, please. Now, here, what are we studying? Bhavan asti bhavantau staha bhavantaha santi, same thing is written once again. So we do with this. Bhavan adhyapakah asti, first sentence. Bhavantau adhyapakau staha bhavantaha adhyapakah santi. Bhavan patayati bhavantau patayatah bhavantaha patayanti. So with each sentence there is another sentence down there which is elaborating that first sentence. For example, Bhavan adhyapaka asti, you are a teacher. What is the next following sentence? Is Bhavan patayati, you are teaching. Since you are a teacher, you teach. So the same thing, like if you remember, I introduced you to two avyayas, two words, you can recall them, yataha and ataha. Do you remember these two?
Yeah.
Since, therefore. These two are avyayas which are no gender derivation required. They don't need to be derived. So we can use that here for the sake of better understanding. Yataha bhavan adhyapakah asti. Since you are a teacher, ataha bhavan patayati, therefore you are teaching. So for every sentence we will add that is yataha and ataha. Second one, bhavan ishwarah asti, bhavantau ishwarau staha, bhavantaha ishwarah santi, bhavan rakshati. Now we will use yataha ataha. यतः भवान ईश्वरः अस्ति अतः भवान रक्षति. सिंस यू आर ए गॉड देयरफॉर यू आर प्रोटेक्टिंग, और सिंस यू आर ए लॉर्ड therefore you are protecting. Then we complete this. Bhavan rakshati, bhavantau rakshatah, bhavantah rakshanti. Fine. Third one. Bhavan naradah asti. Bhavantau naradau stah. Bhavantah naradah santi. Bhavan vicharati. This is a character in Indian mythology. Narada is a sage, celestial sage, who has access to all the seven worlds. He keeps moving from Brahmaloka to Bhuloka without any hindrance, and therefore that is the sentence taken here. Bhavan yataha bhavan naradaha asti ataha bhavan vicharati, and his job is to go to every world and find out how things are going on. So Narada Muni is called Narada Muni. So bhavan vicharati, you can derive bhavantau vicharatah, bhavantah vicharanti. Then fourth, bhavan vaidyah asti, bhavantau vaidyau stah, bhavantah vaidyah santi. Then bhavan chikitsati. Then how do you use? Yatah bhavan vaidyah asti atah bhavan chikitsati. Atah bhavan chikitsati. Since you are a physician, therefore you treat. Bhavan chikitsati, bhavantau chikitsatah, bhavantah chikitsanti. Then fifth one. Bhavan yuvakah asti, bhavantau yuvakau stah, bhavantah yuvakah santi. Bhavan dhavati yatah
bhavan yuvakah asti
atah bhavan dhavati. Yatah bhavan yuvakah asti, since you are a young chap, atah therefore bhavan dhavati. Bhavan dhavati, bhavantau dhavatah, bhavantah dhavanti. Sixth. Bhavan janakah asti, bhavantau janakau stah, bhavantah janakah santi. Bhavan palayasi. The word janakah means pita, father. Literally it means progenitor. You can say progenitor is the begetter, father. So yatah bhavan janakah asti atah bhavan palayasi. Palayati, sorry, palayati. Since you are a father, therefore you are protecting the family. So bhavan palayati, bhavantau palayatah, bhavantah palayanti. So very slowly we are going here, so that you should follow. Then the next part is devoted, next half page is devoted for the usage of the feminine part of this bhavati, what we have written on the board, bhavati. So sentence 1 says here, bhavati adhyapika asti, bhavatyau adhyapike stah, bhavatyah adhyapikah santi. Bhavati patayati, bhavatyau patayatah, bhavatyah patayanti. The same practice you can do. Yatah bhavati adhyapika atah asti atah bhavati patayati. Then second one, bhavati vruddha asti, bhavatyau vruddhe stah, bhavatyah vruddhah santi. So here is, bhavati should be derived like nadi, vruddha should be derived like lata. Vruddha is akaranta strilinga shabda, and it should take the root of akaranta. Bhavati should take the root like nadi shabda. So both derive in two different ways. So be careful here. Bhavati vruddha asti, bhavatyau vruddhestah, bhavatyah vruddhah santi. Bhavati chintayati, yatah bhavati vruddha asti, atah bhavati chintayati. Chintayati means you think a lot, you are thinking. So, ti bhavatyau chintayatah, bhavatyah chintayanti. Third sentence, bhavati agraja asti, bhavatyau agra अग्रजे स्तः भवत्यः अग्रजाः सन्ति भवती स्निह्यति. Here is a new verb is introduced. Snihyati, you love. 5 minutes. You love. So yataha bhavati agraja asti, ataha bhavati snihyati. Sniha to love. Since you are a elder sister, therefore you love me. Understood. So we bhavati snihyati, bhavatyau snihyatah. भवत्यः स्निह्यन्ति स्निह्यन्ति स्निह्यति स्निह्यतः स्निह्यन्ति. फोर्थ, भवती जननी अस्ति भवत्यौ जनन्यौ स्तः भवत्यः जनन्यः सन्ति भवती पालयति. यतः भवती जननी अस्ति अतः भवती पालयति. भवती पालयति भवत्यौ पालयतः भवत्यः पालयन्ति. भवती लेखिका अस्ति भवत्यौ लेखिके स्तः भवत्यः लेखिकाः सन्ति. लेखिका इज अ राइटर. भवती लिखति यतः भवती लेखिका अस्ति अतः भवती लिखति. सिंस यू आर ए राइटर यू देयर फॉर यू राइट. भवती लिखति भवत्यौ लिखतः भवत्यः लिखन्ति. भवती उद्यानपालिका अस्ति बिग वर्ड. भवती उद्यानपालिका अस्ति यू आर अ लेडी गार्डनर. भवत्यौ उद्यानपालिके स्तः भवत्यः उद्यानपालिकाः सन्ति. So don't be frightened with the length of the word. Bhavati sinchati, you water. Since you are a gardener, you watering. Yataha bhavati udyana palika asti, ataha bhavati sinchati. Vrikshan sinchati, you are watering the plants. So bhavati sinchati, bhavatyau sinchataha, bhavatyaha sinchanti. Sinchanti, water. So this is how this today mostly we have studied this honorific pronoun, second person pronoun, but the verb that goes with it is third person. That should not be forgotten. So bhavati bhavan asti bhavantau bhavatyau staha bhavantaha bhavatyaha santi, which is given in the next page. And whenever this pronoun tvam comes, you use second person. With aham pronoun, you use first person. Are we finishing?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. So we'll just look at the page. On 139, just watch avadeyam. Ekavachana, dvivachana, bahuvachana. In the page is giving in detail third person first. Second person next and first person last. Prathama Purusha, Madhyama Purusha and Uttama Purusha. What are the words, pronouns that are coming in Prathama Purusha, third person, are listed in Ekavachana. Eshaha, Eshaha, Etat, Saha, Sa, Tat, Bhavan, Bhavati, Balakaha, Balika, Mitram. All these are third person. Prathama Purusha. And with these words, you use only these verbs. You can say Eshaha Asti, Eshaha Patati, Esha Asti, Esha Patati, Esha Likati. You can use any, pick up any third person verb with these words, pronouns. Next, Dvivachana is same way. What is the Dvivachana dual number of Eshaha? Etau. What is the plural? Eti. So feminine, Esha, Ete, Etaha. Neuter, Etat, Ete, Etane. So gender wise they are given. First masculine, second pronoun is feminine, third pronoun is neuter. Similarly, another pronoun, Saha. Saha is masculine. Saha tau te, sa te taha, tat te tani. And then Bhavachabda is introduced here. Bhavan, Bhavantau, Bhavantaha. Bhavati, Bhavatyau, Bhavatyaha. देन वन मैस्कुलिन नाउन रेगुलर नाउन बालकः अकारांत शब्द बालको बालकाः बालिका शब्द स्त्रीलिंग रेगुलर बालिका बालिके बालिकाः लता लते लताः लाइक एंड वन न्यूटर नाउन विच वी स्टडीड अर्लियर अकारांत नपुंसकलिंग शब्द मित्रम मित्रे मित्राणि सो दीज आर देयर यू प्लीज वॉच देम वील अगेन डू दिस टेक ऑन विद दिस पेज इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास शुभम भूयात्।